Alright, look what time it is. See that? Got it? 4:38. While everybody else sleeping, we out here grinding. Coming from Augusta, man. Everybody else might have school in the morning. I got school in the morning too. The average college student is not doing this right now. Niggas out here tired. Niggas got coffee. You know what I'm saying? I got class in the morning. African American history. Shouts out to Dr. Brown. Clapton University. My nigga Cass on the lens. He done graduated. We out here working, man. Clapton recording stuff. When we get famous, like I said, I told you so, and it paid off.
What do you expect out of life? Do you feel like you have the right plans? One thing about life is things rarely turn out as planned. And your road to success will always present obstacles, barriers, and roadblocks.
It comes at you fast. And what you thought was the plan can change instantly. 7 members, 1 goal, in Stone Mountain, Georgia. Working on records to put out with our new label. Right before we're about to leave for SC, we created our best record called Twerk Day. Then all of a sudden,
that impact was like none other South Carolina artist ever. They toured the entire state of South Carolina and began getting booked for shows in Georgia and North Carolina, creating an incredible fan base ranging from 4 to 50 years of age.
And our shirts and ties and our wardrobe gave people something they weren't used to.
This fresh new look, along with their dance moves and great music, was the perfect recipe for a stage performance.
My ladies in the building, I just wanna see you. You where I want, and now what you need. Baby girl, you fine, and you looking good. You about to waste your money? Girl, I wish you would. Cock that ass bag, cause I got that trigger. Club events, college events, the age limit was limitless. From 2 years old to 50, we had an incredible fan base.
Journey began in 2011, but had an unexpected delay after the group began to question their management about undocumented funds in 2014.
Once I started getting curious about the money, our manager, he began to distance himself.
Some of y'all ain't gonna make it. Some of y'all ain't gonna make it.
Right off the cuff. All for one, one for all.
Jeez.
All for one and one for all.
They soon found that their management was booking shows for $5,000, but telling them that they were being booked for $1,500.
And I know this was all a part of his plan. And the money we made on iTunes, nowhere to be found.
Thus, financially imprisoning this Spiff Kidz.
What up, man? Kyle Santillia, Santillia the Wild Out Wake Up Show, 102 Jams, Be My Triad, North Carolina. Big shout out to the Spiff Kidz. They came on stage, represented. They had their moves like New Edition popping off. They rocked the crowd. They definitely put on for South Carolina. So big shout out to them, man. You already know, man. Peace and love, man. You already know.
Hey, listen, you know I got a motherfucking air for music, right? So I'm going out of town. I forget what state I was going to. And I'm listening to my dog mixtape CD. The shit had like 30 songs on it, right? So I'm like 15 songs in. I ain't really had shit. I'm fucking it like that. Like something that stands out and that's a hit. Until number 16 came on. niggas about to take this shit to another level. They remind me of Boys the Man, BBB, the whole back, the whole fucking ass out there. Something, you know, it ain't always gotta be about slinging dope or gangster or none of that shit, man. We ain't gonna let him put it down for the different motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with this shit. So DJ.